Greetings, Church. 2020 has certainly been an unexpected year. People began the year on social media talking about 2020. Well, there's been plenty of surprises, plenty of anxiety, and certainly a year that's going to go down in the history books. As we're about to start our eighth month of lockdown, I want to say how proud Irene and I of all of you, how you've adapted to all these changes. You've generously given to any benevolence needs that we've brought before the church, and the Northwest is supporting 116 people each month. The Gogos in Soweto now have smartphones donated by all of you so they can watch our online services on YouTube. You've adapted to the new normal, stayed connected through Zoom, and continue to see people baptized and added to our fellowship. Your faith and love for God have shone through this crisis, and we are honored to lead such a wonderful group of Christians. You know, the scripture I wanted to share with us today is 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 1 to 2. Now, I want you to know, dear brothers and sisters, what God in His kindness has done through the churches in Macedonia. They are being tested by many troubles, and they are very poor, but they've also filled with abundant joy, which is overflowed in rich generosity. You know, the Macedonian disciples are famous for showing amazing generosity in the middle of hard times. In fact, for them, it was extremely hard. And yet God's Holy Spirit saw fit to be able to honor them in the Bible for their generous giving in spite of their circumstances. In fact, their giving not only resulted in being honored in the Bible, it also gave them, according to this passage, abundant joy to be able to give. As the Bible says, it is more blessed to give than receive. Right now, church, it is our time for our special contribution. The Northwest Financial Subcommittee has met and identified four areas of need that the special contribution is going to be used for. They are firstly, the COVID-19 Relief Fund. Secondly, the Soweto Ministry Support Fund. Thirdly, Northwest Operations. And finally, our Youth and Ministry Support Fund. Each week, a Northwest Financial Subcommittee member will be presenting the needs of these four areas and the allocation of percentages to all of us. Right now, I'm going to hand over to Fungai Blake, who's going to be explaining the first area of need.
Hello, brothers and sisters. As you know, 2020 has been a really, really difficult year. All of us have been impacted by COVID-19 in one way or the other, whether it's our mental health, our physical health, and for some of us, it's been financial. A lot of brothers and sisters in the church have lost their jobs in the last 6 months. It's been estimated that South Africa has shed over 2.5 million jobs in the last 6 months alone. That's a lot. And for some people, it hasn't been a job loss. It's been a salary cut or a salary freeze. But either way, it's been very hectic financially. As a result, a decision was made to contribute a portion of special contribution to the COVID-19 Relief Fund. This is basically a fund to assist brothers and sisters that are struggling financially during this time. And so this video is about encouraging you to give. If you're able to give, give. It would be remiss of us for there to be brothers and sisters in the church struggling when we are able to help. We're aiming for 4 times our normal monthly contribution. I know it seems like a tall ask. It seems crazy during this time, but we're faithful that God will help us to meet that target. So I encourage you to give. Aside from special contribution, we're also encouraging you to set up a debit order or a payment, scheduled payment, whatever it is that your bank calls it, so that on a monthly basis, you make a commitment to contributing to the relief fund. We know that the recovery is going to be slow, and so we're gonna need your help for many more months to come. So I encourage you to do that. Thank you so much for listening, and God bless.